Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss an important topic. The important in the sense it is important for the students and the teachers. How do we remember information in our mind? So the model what I am going to discuss is Atkinson-Shiffrin model, memory model. They proposed the memory model 1968. We, the teachers, we have a complaint about the students. The students are not able to remember the information for a longer time. They are not able to recall the information, the answer to the question, either in the classroom discussion or in the examination paper. On the other side, the students also, they have a problem. They forget the learning. They are learning, sincerely learning, they are taking good effort in the classroom, but they are not able to remember for a longer time. So if you understand the memory system of our brain, both the teacher and the students, then it is easy for us how to remember the information for a longer time. We all learn from the environment and we all learn from the 5 sense organs of our body. So whatever we learn in our lifetime, it is only through the 5 sense organs: touching, smelling, seeing, hearing, tasting. Thodudal, Nugardal, Parthal, Ketal, Suvaital. The 5 sense organ, touching the body, the skin, smelling the nose, seeing eyes, hearing ears, tasting tongue. So we have 5 sense organs and 5 senses. So whatever we learn, whatever information we conceive from the surrounding or the environment, it is only through the 5 sense organs. So the 5 sense, the information received by the 5 sense organs, it is immediately stored in the sensory memory. So for the sensory memory, it stores the information only for few seconds, short span of time. Then the information is sent to the short term memory. So by when you actually, for the sensory memory, the information, lot of information coming. So in fact, the sensory memory is bombarded with information from all the 5 senses. So the sensory memory receiving millions of information in a short span of time, per second or per minute. இது நம்ம ஈஸியாக நம்மளால் கண்டுபிடிக்க முடியும். நம்ம ஒரு ஒரு இடத்துக்கு ட்ராவல் பண்ணும்போது, டூ வீலரில் போகும்போதோ, பஸ்ஸில் போகும்போதோ, நம்ம நிறைய விஷயங்களை பார்க்குறோம், நிறைய விஷயங்களை கேட்குறோம், பக்கத்தில் உள்ளவங்க பேசுறத கேட்குறோம். ஸோ ஆல் தி இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் தே ஆர் கோயிங், இட் இஸ் சென்ஸ்டு பை அவர் சென்ஸ் ஆர்கன், பட் எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் நாட் கோயிங் டு தி மெமரி. ஸோ ஒன்லி வென் வி ஃபோக்கஸ் த வேல்யூ இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் தே ஆர் ஒன்லி கோயிங் டு தி ஷார்ட் டேர்ம் மெமரி. வி கேன் காரலேட் வித் அவர் மெமரி சிஸ்டம், தி மெமரி சிஸ்டம் வித் தி கம்ப்யூட்டர். ஷார்ட் டேர்ம் மெமரி we can refer to the RAM of the computer. So RAM is processing the information and it is remembering the information for a shorter time. Then in the short term memory, when you continuously rehearsal and maintenance, then we can remember in the short term memory. When we are not rehearsaling, when we are not maintaining the information is lost, forgotten through decay or displacement. This is the short term memory. This we can correlate with our classroom teaching. So classroom la undu first or 30 minutes classroom la first or 10 nimisham nadathina one the information they remember. When you continuously teaching, first 10 nimisham enna nadathramo adu maranduvaan paya. That often happens after 20 minutes or 30 minutes or end of the class. If you ask a question at the first 10 minutes of the classroom, there are many students, they cannot remember. So it is because of continuously when information is flows to the short-term memory, when we are not rehearsing, when we are not maintaining, it will be lost. So how to rehearsal? So we have to rehearsal to remember the information. How to rehearsal? We can write it down. We can keep things on. We can repeatedly tell in our mind so that they can remember in the short-term memory. Then elaborate rehearsal leads to storage in the long-term memory. So when the information is stored in the long-term memory, then only you can retain for a longer time. So again, so from the long-term memory, we will retrain during, suppose there is a question asked in the classroom by a teacher, the students will retrieve the information from the long-term memory, put it in the short-term memory, and from short-term memory, they will answer to the question. So this is how the mind is functioning. So the challenge today for the students as well as the teachers is how to remember the information in the long-term memory. And again, in the long-term memory, there is a problem forgotten through interference and retrieval failure. So what is retrieval failure? Frequently, we will retrieve and rehearse the information. Then only we can remember the information in the long-term memory. Or when there is a disturbance or the interference for the long-term memory, again the information will be lost. So number mind, rendu type of mind irukku ellarum solluvanga, conscious mind and subconscious mind. So we can relate the conscious mind with our short-term memory and the subconscious mind with our long-term memory. And when you compare with the correlate with the computer, long-term memory is something like your hard drive. So short-term memory is something like your RAM. So the challenge today, as I told earlier, the challenge today for teacher, how to put the information in the long-term memory of the students. By practice we can do it. So the practice we can do it. But if you observe the educational system, earlier days, long back, 20 years, 30 years back, by the way of teaching, the teacher impressed the student and the teacher helped the student for putting the information in the long-term memory. So over the years, because of the invention, because of the various reasons, nowadays our students are finding it difficult to remember the information for a longer time. Now I will briefly explain about the sensory memory, short-term memory. So this is what happens. So when you teach, so inside the classroom, when you teach, first 20 minutes, they will remember lot of information, the percentage of retention, right? 60 minutes. At the end of the class, they will remember, suppose you are teaching for 60 minutes or 40 minutes in a classroom. So at the end of the class, they will remember 50% of the information. So look at it here, 30 minutes class or 40 minutes class, 50% of the information. So when you time, elapsing time, right? So at the end of the month, so they may remember only 10% at the maximum. So it is the behavior of the human mind. Unless we practice certain technique for remembering the information in longer time, it is natural behavior of your human brain. So at the beginning, at the beginning of the class, they will be very bright. They will remember 100% information, whatever you tell. When you complete the class, they will remember only 50% information, whatever you taught. And at the end of the month, they will remember maximum of 10% what you taught on the first day. So that is what happening in the human mind. Now, memory, what is memory? Memory is an information processing system. Therefore, we often compare it to the computer. So, compare it to the computer, the short-term memory, we can compare with the RAM, and the long-term memory, we can compare with our hard disk. Memory is the set of process used, encode, store, and retrieve information over different period of time. So, encoding, storing, and retrieval. Encoding, decoding, it is a computer process, right? So whatever the sensory memory is given to the short-term memory, it is it is the encoding the information. And when there is a question, it is again informed decoding. So encoding, decoding is taking place inside the memory. So encoding, what is encoding? So we will see. We get the information into our brain through a process called encoding. So the information received by the sensor, absorbed by the sensor, it is given to the memory after encoding, which is which is the input of information into the memory system. Once we receive the sensory information from the environment, our brain label it and code it. So that is, then we recognize the information with other similar information and connect new concept to the existing concept. This we have to understand. So suppose you are teaching a new concept, new rule to the student. So it is encoded and sent to the memory. Memory is comparing the information, the new information with the existing information, and then recognize it and accept to the storage system. So majority of the time, here where the students are struggling today, because of their mind is already filled with a lot of information, lot of wasteful information, what they collect from the social media. So because of that, their mind is completely full. So when you say new information on the subject, it is very difficult for the mind to recognize and get the information into the brain's memory system. Or a simple example solnumnaka, காலையில் வந்து பஸ்ஸில் வரும்போதோ இல்லை ட்ரெயினில் வரும்போதோ அவன் நார்மலாக மொபைல் ஃபோன் பார்க்கும்போது ஒரு வீடியோ கேம் விளையாண்டுட்டு வந்தாலோ இல்லை ஒரு வீடியோ பார்த்துக்கிட்டு வந்தாலோ அவனுக்கு ஃபஸ்ட்டு டைம் ஃபஸ்ட்டு கிளாஸ் ஃபஸ்ட்டு பீரியட் ஆர் தி டிபெண்டிங் ஆன் தி இம்பேக்ட் ஆஃப் தி வீடியோ கிளாஸ் ரூமில் கவனிக்கும் போது அந்த வீடியோ தான் அவன் மைண்ட்ல ஓடி இருக்குமே ஒழிய நீங்கள் கிளாஸில் நடத்துறது வந்து அவன் மைண்ட்ல போகவே போகாது. தட் இஸ் தி ப்ராப்ளம். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் வி கால் இட் சோஷியல் மீடியா. தி இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் வாட் த வீடியோ வாட் தே சி or the information what they are getting through the social media or the any channel, it is the interference. So how to we cannot immediately say the students who do not see this and that, they will not definitely, the ego will disturb them and they will not accept your advice. So slowly we have to understand and we have to through their behavior, that is what their behavior, listening to the video, listening to the social media is their behavior today. So through influencing their behavior, we have to put the information into their mind. So encoding information occurs through two types of process, automatic processing and effortful processing. What is automatic processing? What is effortful processing? இப்போ உங்கள்கிட்ட ஒருத்தருக்கு ஒரு கேள்வி கேட்குறாங்க, நீ காலை என்ன சாப்பிட்டீங்க, இமீடியட்லி யூ கேன் ஆன்சர். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக் ப்ராசஸிங். ஒரு கேள்வி கேட்குறோம், இமீடியட்லி வி ஆர் கிவிங் தி ஆன்சர். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக் ப்ராசஸிங். ஒரு பிரெயின் இஸ் இமீடியட்லி ரெஸ்பாண்டிங். எஃபர்ட்ஃபுல் ப்ராசஸிங், நாளைக்கு டெஸ்ட்டுக்கு என்ன போர்ஷன் அல்ல நேற்று நடந்த டெஸ்ட்டுக்கு என்ன போர்ஷன் அப்படின்னு கேட்கும்போது அப்போ என்ன பண்ணுது மைண்ட், இட் இஸ் ஒர்க்கிங் வித் சம் எஃபர்ட், இட் இஸ் கிவிங் தி ஆன்சர். தட் இஸ் வாட் எஃபர்ட்ஃபுல் ப்ராசஸிங். ஸோ எனி என்கோடிங் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ரைட், இட் இஸ் த்ரூ ஆட்டோமேட்டிக் ப்ராசஸிங் ஆர் என்கோடிங் எஃபர்ட்ஃபுல் ப்ராசஸிங். அண்ட் தி த்ரீ மெமரிஸ் சென்சரி மெமரி, ஷார்ட் டேர்ம் மெமரி and long term memory, the storage system, right? So sensory, short term and long term memory. Sensory store the information for a couple of seconds, and the short term memory store the information for 20 seconds, and long term memory it remember that happened for days, weeks and years ago. Sensory information, as I told earlier, lot of bombardment of information by the sense organ to the sensory memory. So all the sensory memory information received by the sensory memory, it is not going to the short term memory, right? We cannot store all the information whatever conceived, whatever received by the sensory memory. Only what is valuable, what is important, that is only going to the short term memory. Short term memory, we can remember 7 items in a particular time. 7 information or 7 items, sometimes 9 items, sometimes 5 items in a particular moment, and for a shorter time, 20 seconds. Then immediately after rehearsing, it is sent to the long term memory where we can store the information for a longer time. And if you retrieve the information, there are 3 methods: recall, recognizing and relearning. Relearning, recalling and recognizing is the three method of retrieving the information. Now, what is the challenge today for the teachers? It is how to remember information in the long term memory. So again, long term memory we can again classify into two types. Explicit memories are those we consciously try to remember and recall. For example, if you are studying for your chemistry exam or any examination, the material you are learning will be part of your explicit memory. And implicit memories are memories that are not part of your consciousness. They are the memories formed by the behavior. So, with certain behavior we remember for a longer time. So, implicit memory are also called as non-declarative memory. Now, we can understand that the teachers and the students, you can understand that explicit memory is the area where we have to focus. So, implicit memories in the long-term memory, implicit memory, it is by the behavior. So, if you have a good behavior, you will have good memory, it will be stored in the memory, whatever the behavior, right, everything is stored. Whether this is good or bad, good is good and bad only for the society and only for you. It is not for the mind, it is not for the memory system. So, memory system, whatever you practice, that will be stored. And our focus, what we have to understand is, how to put the information in the explicit memories. So, by practice. So, what are the memory enhancing strategies? Apply the self-reference effect. What is self-reference effect? நிறைய பேர் சொல்லுவாங்க, நீங்கள் படிச்சுட்டு உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்ச மாதிரி எழுதிக்கோங்க, தட் யூ கேன் ரிமெம்பர் ஃபார் எ லாங்கர் டைம். ஸோ இது வந்து எல்லாருக்கும், எல்லா டீச்சர்ஸும் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸுக்கு சொல்கிற ஒரு அட்வைஸ். படித்து புக்கை படிச்சுட்டு உனக்கு எப்படி புரியுதோ அப்படி எழுதி வச்சுக்கோ. தட் இஸ் தி செல்ஃப் ரெஃபரன்ஸ் எஃபெக்ட், தட் இஸ் த மெத்தட், ரைட்? யூ ரீட், ரைட் இட் டவுன் இன் யுவர் ஓன் வேர்ட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் வாட் செல்ஃப் ரெஃபரன்ஸ் மெத்தட். எக்ஸ்பிரசிவ் ரைட்டிங் ஹெல்ப்ஸ் பூஸ்ட் யுவர் ஷார்ட் டேர்ம் மெமரி. எக்ஸ்பிரசிவ், தட் இஸ் வாட் writing in your own way, there is another method. Then beware of interferences, be aware of interferences, right? So the social media is the interference today. We cannot stop the students listening to the social media or going to the working with the social media, but you can limit their time. You can limit when you start to teach through the social media. So there will be their focus, their usage of social media will be an effective way. So that is an interference today. Go get enough sleep, 7 to 8 hours, then only the brain will be active rest of the time. Another method for enhancing your memory is chunking. So instead of organizing the information into manageable chunks, small bit of information, instead of remembering the entire paragraph or a big essay, we can write in bullet point. You can write in the form of bullet point. So when you write in the form of bullet point, by reading, after reading the entire paragraph, entire essay, so what do you can write is, you can write in the form of bullet points. Putting the bullet points, you can write simple sentences. That is what chunking the information. When you have the chunking behavior, chunking the information, you can remember for a longer time. Saying a word out loud improves your memory for the word, right? So loud reading will improve your memory. Then rehearsal or conscious repetition of information to be remembered. So what do you want to remember for a longer time? Rehearsal it, repeatedly tell, right? Consciously repeat, right? That you can remember for a longer time. Then recall the information. So recall is kind of rehearsing, right? Relearn, repeatedly learn, 2-3 times learn, then you can remember for a longer time. Recognize the information. So these are all the methodologies, right? And this is again images, different images. Doing by learning, learning by doing, right? Doing by learning, doing after learning, or learning by doing, right? It is a way to improve your long-term memory capacity. Active learning techniques. So active learning techniques in the classroom, learning in a team and practice, rehearsal, group learning, right? Doubt clarification. So all these techniques, they are the methodology to improve your learning capacity as well as to store the information in your long-term memory so that you can use the information for a longer time. So, if you are a student, you try to practice the group learning technique. You discuss with your friend, discuss with your teacher about the question, about the answer. So, you can clarify, you can get more information, more clear information so that you can remember it. Practice group learning. If you are a teacher, please practice the methodology, right, inside the classroom and help the student to learn better and remember the information for a longer time. So, thank you. We'll meet again with another video lecture.